There have been 862 episodes of Doctor Who broadcast to date. My mission? For every single one, say something nice. Hello dear viewers and welcome back to Say Something Nice. Jump in that bubble trap but take out the bomb because today we are bouncing back to the 1960s. It's the War Games, Episode 3. The War Games Episode 3 got 5.1 million viewers. And the moment I'm choosing from this concerns the series of scenes where the Doctor, Jamie and Zoe have been taken into the German trenches in the World War I zone. In particular, I really love the conversation that the Doctor has with Lieutenant Luke, who is a German officer in charge of this section of the trenches. And so often in 1960s Doctor Who, we get in situations where the Doctor and their friends have been captured and, you know, they can't really explain themselves or how they got there. Now, since episode one of this story, the Doctor has been really quite desperate to get out of No Man's Land and out of the trenches of World War I because he knows what a terrible bloodbath it was. So here, the Doctor, instead of sort of obfuscating and trying to get out that way, as he so often would, and not talk about the TARDIS or anything like that, he straight up tells Luck the truth and pulls out the sonic screwdriver as evidence and unscrews the screws of the gun and puts them back again. And there's that lovely moment where the Doctor says, look, I'll demonstrate. You can keep your hand on the gun if you want. I'm not going to try and take the gun from you. But then, of course, despite the fact that the Doctor is demonstrating he's telling the truth, he does get the gun off Luke. But I think it's a lovely moment because it shows how the Doctor is willing to try and protect Jamie and Zoe and get them out of this situation by going against what he would usually do. You know, this is a Doctor who usually wants to go somewhere and has fun and then discovers that there are people preventing him and others from having fun and therefore they must be dealt with. Instead, here the Doctor is faced with a situation where he knows that staying around for any length of time is dangerous. So he will do everything within his power to get himself, Jamie, and Zoe out of here. There's also the fact that in a war narrative like this, it would be very easy for the production team to present the English characters, such as Lady Jennifer and Lieutenant Carstairs, as being, you know, super intelligent and reliable and what have you, and present the German troops of World War I as beastly and barbaric and horrible. But instead, the soldiers of all the different sides of all the different wars here are presented as just regular people who have their own reasons for why they got involved in this conflict, which then leaves the villain roles open to the people who are manipulating them. And the story is kind of seeking to make commentary on the futility of war and how the different sides in war have more in common than they have dividing them. And this scene, to me, embodies that, because the Doctor is respecting Luke's intelligence the same way he does Carstairs and Jennifer. Even if he does take advantage of Luke's sort of trust and shock to try and get out of the situation, look, that's understandable. He doesn't treat Luke like an enemy, he treats him like a human being in a bad situation. And the Doctor, of course, begins to suspect in this story that the enemy might be somewhere else. And just that little conversation and that little demonstration with the sonic screwdriver is something really nice about the War Games Episode 3. As always, thank you so much for watching. Please do like, share and subscribe, but whatever you do, I hope you enjoy the rest of your day. Do take care of yourselves, and I will see you in the next video.